the 2K Sports pregame show.
As you can
show.
See, this is NBA 2K16.
Welcome to 2K Sports, everybody.
I'm gonna be quiet
us,
so you guys
Andy
can listen
Jones,
to this
Shaquille
before
O'Neal,
I start speaking.
And the Jet Smith. Tonight, it'll be the Chicago Bulls up against the 76ers out in Philadelphia. For Philadelphia, they are digging themselves quite a hole here early in the season. They've lost their first six games. It's getting legitimately worrisome for them. And for the Sixers, this is a team that is relentless in attacking the basket, one of the hallmarks of the team's philosophy.
So,
when they go at the rim with that kind of effort, Shaq, what does it mean for their offense?
You know, it allows them multiple options. They're tougher to contain. They actually led the league last season in drives to the basket. You know, they are relentless, and they finish very hard at the rim.
Yeah, everyone on their team can attack the rim. They seem real comfortable at that, Ernie. But, you know, one thing that they don't have is an outside threat, and that would loosen things up for the guys who can get to the rim that easily.
Philadelphia, you like cheesesteaks?
Geno's, baby.
Oh, man, I love cheesesteaks.
Geno's, I'm on my way.
Yeah, man, I mean, can they send some over?
Oh, that'd be awesome.
Ooh, I smell it already.
Oh, where was I? Oh, here's Kevin Harlan.
Okay, so as you can see, this is 2K16 NBA. For those of you that have watched my NHL videos, you know that I like to do the GM mode where I create myself and a few other players. I've created myself and my cousin Chris, who is my goalie in NHL. So yeah, here we go. I wouldn't consider 16 better than 15, because in my career mode in 16, is, my opinion got awful. Everything else looks great. Oh, by the way, if you are a Bulls fan, I have traded Joakim Noah, so he is no longer on the team. My next goal is to trade Rose.
And as shocked as people are,
I like
they
this.
Would trade away a player of his caliber, Kevin. They didn't just let him go for nothing. Oop. They got a lot in return. I think it's a deal that's going to really help
way
them
too
down
far
the
out.
Road.
Damn it.
And that's the idea. You know, you want to
here we go. Here we go. Come on. I have lost. I've lost two games, actually. As embarrassing it is to say, I lost to Cleveland, and I lost to Oklahoma City.
And they also continue
wide open, baby. There we go. Oh, come on.
Fuck. Jones is out there with the natural.
Then I think I have this on pro.
Then there's Favors.
Oh, fuck. And count the basket. I have it on whatever the setting is. So it's been a while since I've made a video.
Philadelphia shooting their first free throw of the night.
It's been a long time. All right, come on.
And that one misses.
That's good. That's good.
Bulls always seem to be tough on the road, and last
there we go.
No different. They would end
going.
23
oh,
road
fuck,
wins
man.
On the year.
And that number was good enough for the
there we go. Take that.
All
right. So we're
shooting. It's very hard.
Yeah, that's right. You got the foul.
And that's why the Bulls have been so
I like this how
road.
The screen shakes
Chicago
for away free throws.
Free throws of the game right now.
Shoot it, Will.
Hey guys, touching back on the Bulls on the road.
We're
going to
change this to I want offensive
last
glass.
Marked the fifth straight year of a road record above 500. Incredible consistency as a
there
franchise.
We go. There we go.
So we get some both.
Yep, you know, here's another stat for the Bulls on the road. Since 2010,
on in transition. I like to do
the Bulls have won almost 60% of their road
fast
games.
Pace offense.
That's impressive.
Here's Covington. 17 points for him last game against
I can't
Orlando.
Lose this game. That'd be really embarrassing if I lost this game.
Just
especially
five on
since
the clock.
You know they are 0-6.
With the screen. What's up a three? Chicago grabs
you got
the
it, you got it.
They're coming off that win against Minnesota.
And we've talked about
nice.
How in the NBA you've got to earn your points the hard way. And that really
physical
wasn't
defense,
the case in that
I
game
want.
For them.
No, there was no hard way about it. I mean,
protect the paint because they got a lot of big men.
On dunks and layups against the defense that really didn't offer
see how that works out for us.
Here's Okafor after the Bulls pick up
two. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. Look at that. Hell
finish
yeah.
Off the break.
That's what I'm talking about.
At both ends of the floor. They block the shot and recover it for the fast break finish.
Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cotton mouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Oh, damn. They got oh, sweetie miss. I was going to say they got me on that screen.
In the first few minutes, five attempts oop. With only one fall.
Jones dishes to Gobert to the wing right side. Mirotic. The rebound by Roten.
That's what he knows he should have drained.
That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's one for two.
Your heads up aggressive right, here play we go. Right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
Jones drives in. Pass to Mirotić.
Whoa. Okay.
First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play.
And he's yeah, there we go. Nice shot, nice shot.
The Naturals got 5 points so far.
If you're wondering why they keep calling him the Natural, it's because for some reason Kramer is not programmed in their name system. There we go, nice block, nice block. So I had to pick a nickname for him. There we go, baby. There we go.
In the quarter.
Maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that.
And we know he's capable of those memorable dunks.
Yeah, and when he's got keep it a up. Lead keep it up. Like that, why not take a few chances? A lot more engaging and entertaining than just doing the old one-handed.
Right.
The Spurs coaching tree extends pretty far these days. Coach Brett Brown, another former member of the Spurs.
I love the commentary. In my opinion, 2018. NBA 2K well, great games. For Brett Brown and I would even say maybe even they have a slightly better edge in commentary than MLB The Show. But MLB The Show is pretty good. But NBA 2K is better. And then NHL is it's not bad. It's pretty good. It's better than Madden. Madden, in my opinion, is the worst. It's god-awful. I can't speak. I actually know. Madden is second worst. The WWE wrestling games are the worst. I can't speak on NBA Live. They spent a lot of time last season developing their young players. A long time. I want to say probably the last NBA Live game I played might have been 2004 on the PC. Three, wide open three, baby. Oh, come on. All right, so my guy's shooting a little off right now.
Now, here's Roden. Flashed out and we saw him pour in 22. Covington can't connect from 13
feet
out.
He's
going to play right, his go, way Butler. Right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far.
Where's
in
the foul? Yeah, counted. Nice.
And it's clear
good
for
job,
the Sixers. The plan has been to continue to add good young players. Eventually, I think there'll be a force in the East. There's no guarantee, but they've got a plan and they're sticking to it.
Here's Roten. Derek Favors making his last shot. Okafor with a screen on Jones. Roten kicks to Landry.
Fuck.
He makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
And did you see the screen that was set for him? I mean, that was how he got to the hoop.
It was the classic screen play. It won't show up in the box score, but that screen deserves an assist.
Absolutely, Kevin. I mean, that took the defender right out of the play.
So at Chicago now, 76ers getting the bucket out to Favors.
Was,
the offensive rebound.
Oh, sweet. We got it.
The natural.
Oh, damn it. That would have been good. Thought I could have had that one.
Here's Thompson. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him.
Fuck center. Three. Oh, fuck. Okay. We can't allow it. We can't allow that.
Dishes to Landry.
Got to think.
Shoot again.
Out to Thompson. Seriously, guys.
Effort. Can't hit, and okay. Chicago will go okay. The other way with the ball. Butler with the ball, and Roten picks him up defensively.
Nice.
And it's Butler missing.
Jesus.
The 76ers trail by 7. Okay. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin,
where's everybody at? Come on.
Been running in place.
They got to get going.
Okafor
gets the bucket.
The second he got around the pick and right. Shook his man, it was straight
right.
To the bucket for the
make
easy
some subs here.
Very, very well done.
And for Carl Landry, he powered his way to the league a few years back.
I hit the wrong button.
Clark is game kind of
top
shit.
His best okay, well, they made auto subs. All right, Rose.
Injuries have been a factor. But last year was down to 7-4 his game averages, so he's starting to slide.
And the 76ers with a completely new group now.
Let's go, Butler. You got it. Yes. There we go.
Pau Gasol.
Ooh, I didn't think that was a three. That was a two.
Gibson comes in for Derek Favors. And Derek Rose is subbed in for Jones. And here are the 76ers now. After Jimmy Butler made that last 3-point, and Embiid throws it down.
Nothing fancy there. Didn't need it.
Nope. His only concern right now, Clark, is getting the points on the board. And I nice. Don't mean style.
Up the middle. I like that.
Well, there's also style just with the fact that he's able to have that kind of a finish.
The reason I own this game is because it was free for PlayStation Plus, so I'm only like four games in. Get it? There we go.
Tough guy willing to play through pain.
That's not who I wanted to pass the ball to. Should have done it the other way. Fuck. Fuck.
That really has become an issue.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case. It looked like Greg Anthony right there, if I can say so. It was really a case of a yes! good defensive
there we go.
Play
Beautiful
triggering
pass.
Some instant offense.
That's a good
yeah,
setup.
I remember GA as an irritant, and this guy, much like Greg, creating havoc out there.
Dishes it to Noel. And there's a nice one-handed slam.
Man. Up high and down hard with the one hand.
Got a little extra force for that one, didn't he? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and I think that's going to rouse up his teammates, no doubt.
And that one's nice. Good.
There we go.
Rose has got his second basket of the game.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging go. Them like he did. But, boy, that was a nice job.
Here's the natural. No good
on
the buzzer.
I was hoping for a shot at the buzzer.
And that concludes the first quarter of play.
I'll take that. That was
Bulls
a good first
front,
quarter.
They're up by nine. Live from Philadelphia, you're watching 2K Sports.
I like it. It was a good first quarter. Would have been up. I would have liked to have been up by double digits, but that's shit. After losing the last game to Oklahoma City in a blowout, I'll take it.
And Pau Gasol, after some great years and some difficult years, talks about now his
I kinda like this.
Excitement playing with the Chicago Bulls.
I mean, I think it's been noticeable just because this has been my decision, too. And okay, I want to make it good, great, actually. Not good, but great.
I think you'd have to say that Gasol's decision to go to Chicago, Clark, was great. He clearly gave it a lot of thought. It's hard to imagine
sure,
him
let's stick with this.
Made a better pick.
You know, I agree. Not only is he happy, but so are his teammates, Ask Rose and Noah and Butler. Those guys love playing with him, and you can see how the
here we
change
go, here
of
we
scenery
go.
Rejuvenated the big Spaniard, too.
Well, not exactly a close game so far, but as the second quarter starts here, plenty of time for a comeback. Looking at what we've seen for the Bulls, what do you guys think?
Right from the start, they have been able to really own that paint and just dominate the backcourt.
Well, Greg,
I didn't realize I said anything.
All five guys
he's got the ball.
The effort to
yes, go.
And chase down the ball.
On the court right now, second quarter. For the Bulls. Gibson is the four with Gasol at
the five.
It
wasn't as intense as I
Jimmy
thought
Butler
it was going to
be. Out there with Jones. And it's Mirotić in at the small forward.
It's as if
I also realized
just
that
go.
He'll thank them for that.
My two creative players look like monkeys. But that's just because I don't really care about how they look in
the
sports game, really.
Clearly preparing for the playoffs. They played their rookies, but added a lot of playoff seasoned veterans
there we go.
To that roster.
Foul.
And he was
yes!
fouled in the act of
shooting. Nice.
Chance here now for a 3-point play. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for Chicago.
Well, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting
we got it, we got
blocking
it. Right.
Shots.
3-point
definitely
play.
A factor early.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Rudy Gobert, he's checked in for Gasol. And Derek Favors subbed in for Taj Gibson.
Damn.
That's good. Noel's got his second bucket of the night. As you mentioned, the Bulls added veteran leaders last season.
They were starting to press up a little bit.
11 Bulls, Clark, had playoff experience
nice.
Prior
oh,
to
come
their
on.
Run
you got to make that.
Ago.
And that's invaluable, Kevin, to have that kind of experience. I mean, having Gasol, two-time
there we
champion
go.
In the locker room, big, as is having almost a dozen guys
nice.
Who understand the intensity and the details that playoff basketball
gotta
requires.
Got to keep it up like that.
Wow, the floor just really opened up. For him on that possession.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for good offense, but that was just a terrible reaction from the defense. You know, Jimmy Butler is one of those guys who had to overcome major odds just to get to the NBA. Reportedly, his father abandoned the family when Jimmy was an infant. Mom kicked Jimmy out when he was 13. The obstacles and adversity go on and on, yet he's made it and made it big.
Timeout called, the 76ers. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Oh, come on. For Chicago. Shitty ass defense right there. Butler,
and it's the natural in for Jones. And going back to Jimmy Butler,
keep
there
going,
were just so many times when he was set up to fail. He was not heavily recruited out of high school.
Beautiful.
He was even homeless when he was in high school in the Houston area. You know, went to a junior college, then Marquette, now in the NBA. So he played his freshman year at a junior college, which I think humbled him just a bit, but maybe gave him that work ethic that is so much, Greg, a part of his game now.
And, Kevin, the talent was there. And most of all, as we see how he dealt with adversity, the heart was there. He blocked out the distractions and finally transferred to a major college and worked his way into becoming a first-round pick. How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket.
Oh, what the hell?
A pretty pass.
Okay.
Well,
yeah,
when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
Now, here's Moore.
Settle down a little bit. Settle down.
Back to Mirotic. The pass to Gobert.
Get in.
It's hauled in by the 76ers. And going against Chicago, their first meeting of the season.
Yeah, and a four-game season series between these two. Both will be looking to set the tone tonight.
Yeah, and as they renew acquaintances.
Probably could have blocked it, actually.
The underdog, you always want to show, hey, we've got something new up our sleeve. It should be fun.
Last season, the first season of action for Nerlens Noel, officially a rookie. After sitting out the 2014 season, he looked good and he got better as the season was going on.
A great point. I think that year off really helped him grow as a player. Coming into the draft when he came out, he was a guy who I thought had one of the most unbelievable motors I had ever seen. And you know what? Everything he was hyped up to be, he lived up to on the defensive end.
Here's the natural.
Excellent.
17 points for him last game against Minnesota.
And also, he competed on the backboards. That also had a lot to do with the game.
Now, they're really starting to press up their defense.
The lead is
a
15.
Bit.
Shot clock at 3.
Oh, come on. Man, he hasn't made it. Oh, good.
Effort,
oh, shit. That got blocked.
Back.
All right, come on.
And here we go with Thompson running it up the court. That's tipped.
Nice.
Here's the break. It's tipped.
Take it.
Puts up a 3.
I don't know if you can make threes at all, but
the
no, apparently
keep
not.
It alive.
Nice.
Gobert. That's a miss, his second after two shots.
Jesus Christ.
Pass to the natural. And some
there
very
we
quick
go.
Points for him on that possession. The natural's got 5 points in the quarter.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot is until they finally get the one they want.
We got
forget about
things
finesse
around here.
And agility. This big fella's all about power and force.
Chicago calls timeout.
And for Noel, I really think he took off in the back half of the season. Loved his scoring, his shooting percentage, and his rebounding. You can see him getting better almost every game.
All right.
He's checked in for Nerlens Noel. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group here. Taj Gibson's checked in for Gobert. Gasol comes in for Derek Favors. Butler, he's checked in for Etuan Moore. And Derrick Rose is subbed in for the natural. Now here's Butler. 11 points for him in that last game against Minnesota.
Jesus Christ,
Gasol
he can't make anything.
And Philadelphia grabs the miss.
Oh, you should have got that
Landry's
rebound, Gasol.
Landry's got 3 rebounds so far in the game.
None of our guys can make
shot
anything. There we
and
go.
Mirotić sends it back. Here's Butler.
Oh, my God. He just missed the dunk.
Over Landry.
Oh my God! Did he miss?
Pass it to Gibson.
Okay, can we stop
Rose
missing here? Can we really just
Butler
stop missing the shots?
Back to Butler. He dishes it to Mirotić.
Nice. The go in. Good on the there we go. Butler.
Butler's got his fourth assist in this one.
God.
And an open path to the hoop.
I mean, I'm not worried about the score, but we can't make that shit.
Far too many times today.
Now here's Thompson. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game.
Nice.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today. There's a glaring discrepancy between these teams in that area of the game.
And it's been the difference.
Yes, there
That's
we go.
What's enabled them to build such
That's
a big
what I'm
lead.
Talking about.
No doubt about it.
You know, what an advantage he brings to this offense, guys. I mean, being able to drain the three ball, that really can spread a defense and extend the defense as well.
Roten dishes to Okafor. Great D that time from Gibson.
Good rebound.
Hey, they got
Good
the
rebound.
Shot they wanted off of that pick, but it just doesn't fall.
Yeah, it didn't go down, but you'll take that shot every single time, Greg.
Gasol?
That's good offense.
Bounce in?
Almost
have to bounce in.
He's going to knock those down when he is that open.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number Whoa. Of empty ones. A long time without a basket.
They gotta find
I think
he's
going to jump that far.
Jones checked in for Mirotić.
Oh, all right.
Ken Jones.
Forty-one seconds left now here in the second. Makes it off the glass.
You know, the defense has got
here we go.
A much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many
oh,
open
Jesus.
Looks like that.
And it's blocked.
Fuck.
And now the fast break. Grant with the ball.
I said fuck it. It doesn't recognize my command.
Marshall's got his right. first bucket of the night.
That pass into the paint, that is a work of art there. Dead on target.
Jones, the pass to Rose. Back to Jones. Butler on the wing. Outside Gibson. Jones, that's for two. Good.
Yeah.
Jones has got 8 points.
We'll take it.
And really, it looks like he may just try
I
to
shall
take, this
take
thing
it.
Over on his own and really build that lead up.
And so a pretty lopsided game
it's
for the first half.
Half right there.
Bulls lead by 18. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Hi, Kevin. I'm here with Derek. And Derek, what are the most important things you've done defensively tonight to help your offensive approach?
Contesting their shots. They're a great three-point shooting team. We were just contesting.
No, they're not.
Get out and run. That's our favorite thing.
No, they're, you're
get
a fucking idiot. They're not a great three-point
shooting
team.
Shooters on the floor.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
I'll be quiet during this again.
Ernie Johnson here again with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. We welcome you back to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Chicago came ready to play. Tenacious on both ends of the floor, they took command early with a 13-2 run. They were able to string together a nice set of offensive plays to finish the quarter, making their last four shots. Then in quarter number two, it was all hands on deck, and what a show it was. Quality execution, good efficiency, some tremendous defensive play helped them take a decisive advantage, and they're running away with this one. And Kenny, what did you think about what you saw from Chicago?
Well, they knocked the wind out of the defense in transition, converting fast break baskets in volume. It's a runaway lead right now. In fact, this looks like a track meet.
Shaq, what'd you think about Philadelphia?
Well, first of all, Ernie, they were atrocious on the boards. Getting tough on the glass has got to be the first thing they address. There is no way they can come back into the game unless they show more fight in the paint. If not, Ernie, they're going to be barbecue chicken.
All right, that is going to wrap up our
halftime
report.
Barbecue chicken, apparently. All right, here we go. Third quarter.
Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the third and fourth quarters.
Talk about complete control. Everything working in this one for the Natural. 15 points, and the three-pointers have been dropping for him. He's got three of them.
And you know what, Clark? If you continue to shoot the way he is, he may have to become more of an integral part of their offensive scheme.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball.
Okay, he missed.
So on the floor for Philadelphia, they've got Hollis Thompson,
Robert Covington out there with Carl Landry.
Nice.
Then there's Okafor.
I got to make sure. Okay, that's the same.
And after his last game, really not surprised to see him as hot as he is here tonight.
Whoa. And Thompson. Okay, something happened there with Kramer.
Roten's got three assists tonight.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Well, the defensive rotations, Greg, have been a step
nice.
Slow.
Really just run around everybody.
Ball inside time after time.
Nice move and finish. I think the halftime break really gave him a second win. And guys, this 76ers team still trying to forge an identity. One thing that is sure, they will attack
oh, fuck.
The basket.
Nice.
And a lot of fearless players.
Here we go. Here we go. Fast break.
Roster.
Fast break.
Now here's Jones.
Oh,
wow. And so it looks like the Bulls will retain possession here.
That was a hell of a block. I kind of want to see, let's see, squares zoom out. I just want to see how, like, where exactly this ball goes. And if it mean, if they maintain, oh, jeez, that was a hell of a block.
Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Favors with the wide
oh my god, I did not realize that was him. That was a horrible
Jones with it.
That was somebody else.
Jones, the pass to the natural. Outside Favors. Here's Mirotić. Well, it
got
was
it.
Only a matter of time, but they finally get the bucket. Mirotić yeah. has got seven.
And really, the Bulls weathered a lot of injuries last season and still had a good showing in the East.
Came I'm not doing any subs. I'm happy with the way we're going right now.
So many games from key players.
However,
checked in for the 76ers.
We keep it up, I might just be putting the whole bench in because
now here's Roten. He's guarded closely. And Noel
probably, I probably won't
Covington.
Do that though, depending on the score at the start of the fourth.
There's a screen by Noel. Covington dishes to Noel.
Ah.
And Derek Favors picks up the foul. And the Bulls did end up with the third seed in the East. 33 of their 50 wins last year, Clark, coming in the Eastern Conference.
But it wasn't.
In case you're wondering what that sound is, that would be the rain.
Of those wins for the Bulls.
Oh,
against their own division in the Southeast, they played 500 basketball. They got their good in-conference record.
God damn.
Feasting on the Atlantic team, taking 16 wins in 18 games against that division.
Here we go.
Now here's Jones. He's covered by Roten. They get it back. Here's Favors.
Oh.
And Okafor with the block.
Jesus.
And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession. Here's the natural. 17 points in the game. Here's Mirotić.
That's in.
And the three ball
yeah.
is good.
Yeah.
Mirotić has got 10 points.
And that's one of his strengths, knocking down those long-range jump shots.
Roten kicks to Covington. There's a screen
watch him,
by Noel.
Watch him.
Covington shot
got
is
it.
Off.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They
over.
It's been about tempo and pace with this group, and it's led to a huge advantage in fast break points.
Greg,
so I'm
it's
talking
really the
about,
main
man.
Reason they're in front. All that early offense. I mean, when they've had the chance to push it, they've pushed it.
Yep.
Here's Covington. Okafor with a screen on Mirotić. The feed to Noel. And the foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Damn.
It's going to be on Rudy Gobert.
Yeah, the defender all over him.
Greg, he got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
For Philadelphia, they have hit just two free throws and five attempts today. And that one falls for Okafor.
Well, guys, once again, the 76ers finished second to last in the East. Amazingly managed to win fewer games against the East than they did the year before, which was 14 wins in 2014.
Jimmy Butler, he's checked in for Mirotić.
Here we go. Come on. Push it up.
Now here's Jones, guarded closely. Butler in the corner. Passes it to the natural. Jones kicks to Favors. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Five on the clock.
Nice.
And plenty of contact on the shot. So two free throws coming up. One thing, Greg, about Philadelphia, you talked about this. Only 12 wins for them last year against the East.
There we go. There we go.
Not getting a win against their own conference until December. I mean, as bad as the Sixers were last year, though, they weren't the worst. So sometimes, even for me, I still can't fathom that's the case.
Pau Gasol's checked in for the Bulls. And guys,
he missed.
Embiid, third overall, despite a foot injury that would keep him out all of his rookie season, came to the Sixers with a back issue out of Kansas. Of course, they knew all this going in.
Yeah, and Kevin, the Sixers have made an art here lately of drafting players who aren't eligible to play. 2 years ago was Nerlens Noel, who set out the season with a knee injury. Last year was Dario Saric, who played overseas, and now Embiid.
Some solid defense from Butler.
And he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense didn't give up on that play. And
fuck. Getting careless
with
now.
It, kicks it to Embiid. There's the killer two-handed slam.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there.
Okay. Okay.
You know, regarding Joel Embiid, the foot was not his only injury when he entered the draft. In his one season at Kansas, he battled knee injury. Obviously, though he's very young, his durability is of some concern.
And that one's good. Roten.
Okay.
Roten's got 4 points now in the quarter.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
That's got to be job number one right now. Nothing easy on the inside.
I wanted to do some,
but... The 76ers making a change here. Chicago also making some changes.
Sure.
Taj Gibson's checked in for Rudy Gobert.
Fuck.
And Derrick Rose is subbed in for Jones.
2 minutes. 2 minutes left in the third quarter.
He's covered by Rose. 1:52 left to play in the third. Here's Noel. And he uses the glass on the layup. Noel's got 8 points.
Can we start doing something here?
And talking about Joel Embiid, there are some who feel the Sixers targeted guys in the draft last year who couldn't help them win games. One wonders at what point does it become anti-competitive.
That's good.
There we go.
Gasol's got his first points of the night.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
He's covered by Rose. There's a screen by Noel. Feeds it to Marshall. There's the dish to Noel. Shoots from 12.
Here's Embiid.
And plenty of contact on the shot. So, 2 free throws coming up. And Chicago call for the foul. And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Bulls?
Boy, their passing has been picturesque. A thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
Yeah, but also, they haven't missed a beat in terms of their fast break game. That's been equally as effective all night long.
Carl Landry's checked in for Noel. Butler on the wing. Back to Rose. Right wing. Here's the natural.
Yeah.
The Bulls from deep.
And he know what? He's got a new BFF. It's the triple.
And it has been his BFF today, anyway. Most of his points have been courtesy of the deep ball.
Down low, and Embiid throws it down.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
The Bulls leading by 17. And now the fast break. Grant with the ball. Comes up empty down low.
Oh, nice play on D. Got that hand in the face and prevented him there from getting an easy look.
Damn it. That should have been.
Really
that would have been beautiful.
Quickly for that shot attempt.
I don't understand.
The 76ers have gone 6 of 9 at the line.
Carl Landry at the line for 2.
And the first one drops.
Boy, perfect half at the free throw line for him. That'll help their comeback effort for real.
And Clark, those free throws need to continue if they're going to get back in this game.
Second free throw, no good. Chicago's gotten a positive outcome on 7 of their 14 three-pointers in this game. Not bad at all. The natural, the pass to Favors. Butler dishes to Favors.
Nice.
The shot's good on the assist by Butler. 6 points for Derek Favors.
And just a step ahead of the...
Oh, no. Bad time to slip up there, Kevin. They got to stay focused.
What?
And taking a technical there is the technical? Last thing you want to do. The what? Opposite of smart basketball.
For Philadelphia, they have gone 7 of
Where
11
was the
from
technical
the line.
Foul? What happened?
And that one misses.
I didn't say anything. Whatever. He missed anyways, so I don't really care about where the technical
the
foul
quarter,
was.
It's a double-digit ball game. Bulls out front. They lead by 18. And do not go away.
Not bad. Not bad. Not happy with the third
Welcome
quarter
back.
Performance.
Quarter action starting up in what has been a one-sided
All right.
show.
Let's put you in. Put you in. Let's put you in. We'll put some new guys in there.
Here's Snell. So for Chicago right now, Etwan Moore is out there with Favors. And
there we
Dunleavy,
go. Look at that. That was beautiful.
And it's Gobert in its center.
You know, I don't think it's ever too late to make a sweet dime. I mean, even if you're halfway through your shot, you might find a better one with four teammates.
Landry with the screen. Roden kicks to Thompson. Here's Landry. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys.
Beautiful play.
Shots
there
good.
We go.
I like the fact that he led his teammate right to the ideal spots. You don't always throw it to your teammate. You throw it to where he needs to be.
Now, here's Roten. He feeds it to Okafor. Here's Covington. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
Wow.
And they've got to talk to each other on D there. Miscommunication, and now he's able to make him pay.
Here's Snell, and he dunks it down.
Fellas, that two-hand monster slam was vicious.
I don't think there was anyone.
I don't really, I guess,
I mean
they're not, I guess,
stopped
they
stopped
have everyone over
you,
on the other
I'm
side.
I'm glad they didn't try, because somebody might have got their feelings hurt.
Landry against Favors. With some arc. Here's Roten. An amazing finish
Damn.
With a hand right in his face.
And the defense just gets caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance opportunity.
You know, that just can't happen. They need much more effort than that on the glass. Tell you what, he's not an easy guy to stop when he's got his sight on the rim.
Never has been, never will be.
He good start
is
to the fourth quarter.
Finish.
Did he just go chop there and put that one in?
Okay.
Tomahawk slam.
And Philadelphia calls time here.
You know, as I watched Derek Favors last season, he continued to develop his offense. He was a big, unpolished athlete coming into the league, had some conditioning problems, but now it seems like he's on track to be a force as a power forward.
Nerlens Noel checks in for Philadelphia. And the Bulls making a change here as well. McDermott's checked in. And here's Covington from the arc. Gobert pulls it in. Gobert's got his sixth rebound
here
on the night.
Here we go.
Talking about Derek Favors, his points per game average went up last season, as it was done in each of his six seasons in the league. He's an ascending player.
He has, you know, definitely refined his moves down on the blocks, and he's also become much improved at passing out of the double team, averaging a career high in assists last season as well. The arrow is certainly pointing up for Mr. Favors.
Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. And Moore kicks to Favors. To the paint. Got a piece of it. Gobert.
Oh, come on.
By Covington.
How'd you miss that?
Covington's got three rebounds now in this one. Pass to Roten. He's looking for Okafor and finds him.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on him.
McDermott can't get it to go.
Yeah, that was like an air ball.
Looking at Philadelphia, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Magic. And there's Thompson. That's good on the assist from Roten.
And that's his strong suit, the ability to find his way through the D and finish at the rim.
And Moore kicks to Favors. Over to the left wing. Here's Snell.
Going.
Lays it
nice.
In without an inch of room around him. Snell's got 4 points this quarter.
Like,
and boy, did he ever sell
like
the pump
fake. The crowd silent.
Absolute perfection.
4-3, Covington. That's good. Covington's got a pair of threes
right.
here in the fourth quarter right. for Philadelphia.
Their three-point percentage has taken a big leap here in this second half.
And their lasers are starting to do their thing. I mean, that's going to be the ticket for them the rest of the way.
I'll take that, yep.
Changes for Chicago. Miritich has checked in for each one more. The natural comes in for Doug McDermott.
Right, right.
And Jones subbed in for Tony Snell. And it's slammed in by Jones.
It's hard to believe that he's a point guard. I mean, he can power those dunks down as well as any big man in the league.
If not better, if not better. He's a phenomenal finisher.
Enjoy seeing
yeah, like
that
you're really
kind of bounce
shoot
out of that spot on the floor.
Nice try.
Picked by Okafor, and here's Covington Fox. From the arc.
Hey.
No luck.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole because he is just not there offensively.
To the left wing. And Miritich kicks to Jones. Dishes it to Gobert. There's the pass to the natural. And misses
yeah.
it off the right side of the rim. The 76ers trail by 18.
I was playing with the ball too much on that one. Come on.
Picked by Okafor. Pass to Covington. Okafor with a screen on Jones. Covington kicks to Noel. Five on the clock. Connects
Ooh.
On the foul line jumper.
Come on.
The Bulls leading by 16. Outside, Jones. He kicks it to Gobert. Here's the natural. He's covered by Thompson. Here's Miritich. Traps in the
nice.
Tray.
What you
and
get
the Bulls
not guarding,
by 19.
Not playing tight on him.
And really, with every point from this point on, it seems like they're just closer to finishing this one off.
If they haven't already done it. I mean, hey, it's been a tremendous all-around performance from this group.
Did it?
I don't think there's any question about that. He got a great read of where that miss was going, and that allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
Here we go, here we go.
Now here's Jones. He's covered by Roten. Out to the right wing.
But they really have Kramer guarded well.
Here's the natural. He's covered by Thompson.
Oh, my God.
Gobert can't
Did not expect you to go out all
totally
the way.
Out of whack right now. He's lost his feel for the shot.
Whoa,
yeah, he
shit.
Really has. I mean, just
nice.
Totally out of sync. I mean, you can just see it in the numbers. Nothing going down for him right now.
Second shot opportunity.
Damn
so
it.
The whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Looking at the game so far for Okafor, he's got 10 points and he's rejected a shot over the course of the game too.
And it easily could have been more. He's played an effective game at that end of the floor.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Pau Gasol is checked in for Gobert. Gibson comes in for Derek Favors. And Derek Rose is subbed in for Jones.
And guys, what we saw here tonight
nice.
Is one
yes.
side
and
having
one.
Everything going for them.
That's what I'm talking about.
Margin of victory for Chicago.
You know, Clark, when you shoot this well from three-point range, you're really hard to stop. The defense didn't rotate out fast enough to stop the hot shooters.
Well, you said it all there, Kevin. They were lethal from behind the arc.
And so with this win, they'll move to six victories on the season.
They can chalk this one up, but these two teams will see plenty more of one another before the season's over.
And, Greg, we know familiarity breeds contempt. I would expect things to become more heated as these teams
going.
Face each other going
Damn
forward.
It.
I mean, when you look at the stats, you'll
oh,
see
shit.
Just...
Oh, no. Bad time to slip up there.
Oh, are you fucking kidding me?
And taking a technical there
are
is
you
the last
fucking
thing
kidding
you
me?
Want to do.
Fuck
the
you,
opposite
ref.
Of smart basketball.
Fuck you. Give me a technical on that. Fuck you, ref. Fuck you. Fuck you, ref.
And the free throw, no good.
Yeah, that's right. You missed
well,
again,
the plan
you little
pansy-ass
bitch.
Has been obvious now, Clark, for a while. The 76ers
suck, ref.
Really loading up on young players,
you
letting
suck.
Them see a lot of minutes, and They're hoping it's going to bear some fruit, as you like to say, coming up.
Exactly, and it will in time because they've accumulated some really nice young talent, Kevin.
Get out of my way, you bitch. Yeah, that's right. You can't make two technical goddamn fucking
at the elbow, it's Gasol
free throws.
With the shot.
It's Rose.
And again, no good by Chicago. Now Marshall puts it up from 12, and there's Embiid. That's good on the assist from Marshall. And here's Rose. Here's the natural. And that one.
And he made it.
Well, guys, they came in here and really took
charge. Yeah, that's right, you bitch.
From the opening tip.
Yeah,
this
number 12, you ain't got shit.
To do for a visiting team.
You can't guard him.
This contest was played on their turn.
Yeah, I
and you know, that's
bitch.
Not the way it usually works in the NBA. It's going to be
fight?
A great win,
can we,
and
we
you
fight?
Know it's going to be a happy plane ride out of here for sure.
That was that was at the end of the game. The game's over. Yeah, that's right. You can't guard him. You can't guard him. Beautiful game. Beautiful game.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
We'll watch this really quick.
And Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Let's take a look at our Jordan player of the game.
His accuracy from the field was pretty eye-catching. I mean, if he was shooting the ball, it was going in. You rarely see a performance like this with this crazy high shooting.
28 points. Wow. Holy shit.
He had 5 3-pointers tonight, and that was a big factor in the win.
And
the D, they weren't giving him the shots. He was taking them. Tight defense. Man, he kept moving, kept working, getting open. Great looks, great work ethic by our guy tonight.
And
all right, guys.
That'll do it for tonight.
Thanks for
Kenny
tuning
Smith,
in.
Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin
Harlan. Hope you enjoyed it, and see you again next time.
2K.